evening. Welcome to Colonia High School for our 2023 Spring Band Concert. Kids are really excited to perform for you. We've been working very hard this semester. We just ask a couple things. Please do not open the doors. Don't leave in between songs. It's the only time you can leave and open the doors, so please stay seated. And please don't use cell phones during the performance. And of course, no flash photography. Thank you. Concert band made up of all of our band students. This year's concert features quite a few classic band pieces and classic composers, a lot of standards, things that I think all high school band students should play, and musicians and composers I think that they should play. Our first piece was written in 1939 and premiered in London's Royal Albert Hall, as you might have guessed from the fanfare-like sound. And that was Flourish for Wind Band. And at this time, I'd like to introduce our first student announcer, Sabrina.
Francis Macbeth was an American composer whose wind band works are highly respected. They are still some of the most popular among bands across the country over 50 years later. Our next piece, Phrases, features echoing melodies throughout the band, changing time signatures in a beautiful but sad woodwind melody before building to an exciting finish. We hope you enjoy Phrases.
Thank you. In 2021, American singer-songwriter Lin Manuel Miranda, who had previously worked on Moana, wrote the score to Disney's Encanto, which featured 8 original songs in both Spanish and English. The soundtrack has been praised for its authenticity in capturing the music of Colombia while incorporating salsa, tango, and reggaeton styles alongside pop, hip-hop, folk, and musical theater elements. We are happy to present 5 of these award-winning songs. We hope that you enjoy The Family Madrigal, We Don't Talk About Bruno, 2 Oruguitas, Surface Pressure, and Waiting on a Miracle from Encanto.
Thank you.
Okay. A maelstrom is described as an intense whirling mass of water circling itself with great strength. This is an inspiration composer Robert W. Smith launches the splendid work, The Maelstrom. This song successfully captures the beauty and power of a fierce storm with variety of musical techniques. Composer Robert W. Smith is a legend in the music industry that all high school students should know, as he composed over 700 pieces for band. We hope that you can feel the power and enjoy the haunting flourishes of The Maelstrom.
Thank you.
For our final number, the concert band would like to present an arrangement of two patriotic songs skillfully weaved together into a march. Our marching band was also proud to perform this song in the 2022 Woodbridge Veterans Day Parade. And we're also very excited to perform this song next week on a trip to Cleveland, Ohio. Please enjoy your grand old flag and America the people.
We will be changing the stage over for Wind Ensemble. The Wind Ensemble is a group of 10th, 11th, and 12th graders who are also a part of the concert band. But the Wind Ensemble students learn additional material, and they learn higher level material. And it's a little bit more soloistic, as we have pretty much one on a part. So before we get to the Wind Ensemble, I'd like to say couple of thank yous. We'd like to thank the Woodbridge Board of Education for all their support, and Mr. Pace and Ms. DiChiara and the entire faculty of Colonia High School for all of their support as well. We definitely want to give a special thank you to the Marching Patriots Parents Organization, especially our board. It's been a great year, all because of the dedication of the parents, so please give a hand to our members, especially our board members. And I want to thank my marching band staff for the many, many hours they spent with not only me, but the students especially, putting in all of that extra time and work on the weekends, especially in the fall. But as we mentioned, we'll be going to Cleveland, Ohio next weekend. So it's all because of the dedication of our staff. So thank you to Mr. Barbado, Mr. Leibner, and Ms. Donahue for all of their help. And I want to give a special shout out for Ms. Gross for doing the lights, otherwise you wouldn't see me. And for Mr. Aspie for opening the doors. And he makes great balloon animals. You might not know that, but Mr. Aspie, it's very talented, so thank you guys for your help tonight. And all of the staff who's here helping out, thank you very much. And last but not least, I'd like to give a very, very special thank you to the parents for supporting Music Ed and for pushing your students. There's definitely a time when it was hard, when it was challenging, when your child came home and said, I don't know if I want to do this anymore. And a lot of other parents might have said, okay, you can quit. But you saw that talent and you saw the benefit in music. And I want to thank you for pushing your child to not only start, but to continue. And I hope that now you can appreciate the fruits of all that hard work and time spent and the renting of the instruments and driving to the practices. It's definitely paid off As far as I'm concerned, I'm very blessed to work with talented students. So thank you to the parents for supporting music and music education. Give yourselves a round of applause. Okay, our wind ensemble is ready. Our first piece is Toccata for Band. This is an extremely popular piece among high school bands and college bands since it was published in 1957. It features two main themes, a quick and rhythmic melody, and then a second theme, a slower, more emotional section featuring various solos. So I hope you enjoy Toccata for Band. Thank you.
Our next piece is based on a beautiful Scottish folk song told from the point of view of two Scottish soldiers. One soldier was to be executed while the other was to be set free. The song is from the point of view of a soldier who will be executed. He sings, "You will take the high road and I'll take the low road, and I'll be in Scotland before you. But me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Holm." In the song, the spirit of the dead soldier shall arrive first to be in the low road, while a living soldier will take the high road over the mountains to arrive afterwards. Sadly, the soldier is accepting his fate while remembering meeting his love in the beautiful Scottish countryside. Frank Capelli preserves this folk song's simple charm while also suggesting a sense of hope and the resilience of the human spirit. The final statement masterfully combines the Scottish tune with the well-known Irish folk song, Danny Boy. We hope that you enjoy Loch Holm.
Thank you.
Right, at this time, I'd like to present our first award, named in the honor of John Philip Sousa. If you don't know who he was basically the first big American music celebrity. He wrote over 100 marches, and he was a celebrity in his day. So think, who's a celebrity these days? I don't want to date myself, so. I don't even know who's popular. But anyway, he was more popular than them. So he would travel around and play his marches, and he standardized the march form, which is basically the first American contribution to music in terms of a form. All of our music is borrowed from other places up until about the turn of the century. So this award is named after John Philip Sousa. It's given out to to a high school student in many, many schools across the country. And we've been giving it out here, I think, for about 15 years. So the winner will receive a certificate, a plaque, a pin, and they'll have their name engraved on the plaque and on the wall for many, many years to come. So this year is my pleasure to announce the winner of the John Philip Sousa Award is Jaden Solomon.
The dictionary defines ruckus as a noisy commotion, raucous, or rumpus. And this very original work is just that. Loud, boisterous, aggressive, and mixed meter. Heavy percussion and thumping rhythm give this piece a decidedly urban feel. We think that you will be musically entranced by this powerfully rhythmic yet sophisticated work. Here is Ruckus.
Thank you.
have a few important dates. It's a busy time of year. So on Saturday, we have our pocketbook bingo / tricky tray run by the band parents. And that's this Saturday in the gym. Next Thursday, the Marching Patriots leave for Cleveland, as we stated before. So we'll be performing at Cedar Point Amusement Park. We'll be visiting the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And we'll also be taking a clinic with some professors from Baldwin Wallace University. So that's a great trip we're looking forward to. And that's next Thursday. Our meeting for next year's marching band most likely will be June 1st. So anybody interested in joining next year's marching band, look out for that meeting on June 1st. And we have our awards dinner for the Marching Patriots on June 10th. And our final performance with all of these students will be at graduation, which is on June 21st. And that's our final performance. And I also want to mention, we had some students perform with the District Honors Band this year. The District Honors Band, if you don't know, is made up of students from all three high schools here in town. And we also have about a dozen performers who are teachers and staff members in the district. So it's a great group because we come together as an entire district. And I think the best part about that group is they get to perform under the baton of a college professor. So this year they performed with Dr. Balmanis from Rutgers University. So that was a great concert in February. So I just want to recognize those students because their names aren't in the program. So it's Abigail Tavrovetsky, Chris Rodriguez, Jaden Solomon, Roxanne Rotuzniak, Carly Escudero, Elias Geraldo, Heidi Nessler, Donovan Magalinas, Kayla Gould, and Kayla Young. So how about a round of applause for those students who performed for the District Honors Band. And it looks like we're almost ready for the Jazz Band. The Jazz Band is a select group. We have auditions in September, and we perform from October all the way through June. We perform at various school events. We perform a variety of music, obviously jazz, but there's a high value placed on improvisation and history of music. So we perform other styles as well, Latin. You'll hear a rock song tonight. So this is a great group, a lot of fun. We rehearse once a week, and you'll hear various students taking solos. They are improvised, and they've been working on them all semester. Are we about ready? We need to close the back curtain. But it looks like we're about ready, so this is our jazz band. Thank you. Time flies, we're having fun. Well, before we play our last song, we do have one more award. This award is the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award. Very similar to the Sousa Award for Band, this award is for jazz. We've been giving it out for 15 years. So the winner will receive a certificate and a plaque and a pin and their name engraved on the wall for forever, forever and ever and ever. So this year's award, the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award, it's my pleasure to present to Ryan Figueroa. Especially for all of their hard work and dedication over the last 4 years. It's my pleasure to get to teach such great students, such fine young people. I don't think we hear enough about the good that goes on, especially with our students. So whenever we can celebrate them, I think we should. And there's no better way than this. This is a cheat-proof test right here. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to realize that these students worked hard and learned a lot and are very talented. So I'm very, very lucky to work with them, and I especially want to say thank you and good luck to our seniors. How about a round of applause for our seniors in the audience and up on stage. It really is my pleasure, and I hope you guys come back soon and visit and keep in touch. Okay, this is our last song for the jazz band. Thank you very much for coming. Really appreciate it, and I hope you have a great time. Thank you.